What is good, everybody? Today we're talking about Disintegration, the new FPS meets RTS game from V1 Interactive and Private Division. This game comes out June 16th for Xbox One, PS4, and the PC via Steam for $49.99. I want to thank the Private Division for sending me over a code so that I could share my impressions with you guys. This is a really cool and unique game with plenty of things I like and a few things that I'm not too sure about just yet. Now, the game is built by V1 Interactive. This is the new 30-person indie studio founded by Marcus Lehto, the co-creator of Halo. If you guys have seen any of the old Halo Vidocs, you'll definitely recognize this guy. Now, it is an FPS game at its core, but there is a ton of RTS gameplay elements included to where you need to issue commands effectively in order to control a group of three hero units fighting below you. Yeah, that's the other unique twist on the FPS side of the game. You are on a grav cycle. This grav cycle allows you to hover above the ground, 15, 30 feet above the action. You can boost, you can fly in all directions while your ground troops run and follow below you. You have a weapon and you also have abilities such as healing that you need to issue regularly in order to succeed. But the real mastery here and the really cool element about Disintegration and what makes it so unique is the fact that you have to use both elements in tandem with one another in order to succeed. If you're just flying around playing the game like an FPS, you're not going to be able to complete things on harder difficulties and you're not going to get the full picture. And vice versa, if you're only issuing commands and only using units' abilities, it's not going to actually lead to that beautiful synthesis that Disintegration can occupy. So as I mentioned, there are some things I like about it and some things that I don't like all that much. I'm going to be focusing only on the single player as I don't think I can talk about multiplayer until after the 16th. This game does have a multiplayer component. It looks pretty cool. There's lots of unlockables, great art design, but let's just focus on single player for now. I really liked the unique gameplay experience that this RTS-FPS hybrid combines, and I think a lot of players will like it as well. Essentially, you need to command your units to certain locations on the battlefield that are advantageous. You issue commands such as focus firing down certain targets and using your unit's abilities. Things like throwing down a giant AoE bubble that slows time for all enemies who enter that space. Or how about placing a grenade on that enemy? Or utilizing a mortar strike? Those are things that you're going to be doing very regularly. There's plenty of on-map items too that you can issue commands for your units to interact with, such as healing packs or big electrical coils that you need to take out to deal big AoE damage on enemies coming through a choke point. From the FPS perspective, you're going to be flying around the battlefield, shooting at enemies, and then also healing your teammates. Beyond the sort of basic bare bones mechanics there, most of the missions have a unique twist within them that require you to either move to certain points within certain timeframes or just add additional twists on top of the gameplay kick. Another thing I really liked about this game was its polished presentation. The character designs are really rad. This futuristic universe has a new process known as integration, which is how human beings preserve their brains by placing them inside robotic armatures. As such, there's really cool character designs, great voice acting, nice cutscenes, and this universe seems very rich. Like, from the very get-go, I was like, man, for such a small team, I'm really impressed with how polished the overall presentation feels. Aside from the music, I wasn't overly hyped with the music. It felt like that area of the game could use maybe a little bit of a punch up. But this fresh blend of RTS command issuing gameplay with FPS gameplay was pretty nice, to be honest with you. The AI teammates tend to behave fairly well. They pathed pretty regularly, they followed me around, and I never found myself overly frustrated with their actions. Although, sometimes they don't really use cover in the ways that you want them to. Let's say you issue a command to go right behind this truck. Oftentimes, they would scurry around the outside of the truck and not really utilize the cover in the way that I wanted them to. You do have to micromanage these guys pretty heavily to get the most out of their potential, which can feel maybe a little bit babysitting-esque for some players. For me, I thought it was kind of fun. It gave a nice blend of, oh, I need to attack this person here. Oh, I gotta shoot this dude over here. Fire my AoE heal over on that hero who's starting to look low. It's a lot like the hero missions in Warcraft 3 or Starcraft 2, with the added benefit that you have your own mobility and damage output potential. So you should never really be all that bored within some of the later missions. There's plenty to do and always a sense of reward when you overcome some of the tougher encounters. And honestly, the thing I liked the most was the fact that it's just a fresh take. I don't think I've experienced any other games quite like this, and that is cool, and I want to applaud that level of creativity. On some of the elements that I didn't like so much, the plot pacing feels a little bit off, especially for the first few missions. They were painfully slow, in my opinion, at least in terms of the mechanics that it was throwing at you. You've got RTS length mission, so 20-30 minutes depending on the difficulty that you're playing it on, and before there's a lot of extra gameplay twists thrown at you, it was a little bit dull. However, as the campaign progressed and they added more twists within each mission, I found myself getting more and more engaged with the game. Additionally, as I pointed out, the music seems extremely lacking. It's maybe the one part of the game that I think could have punched it up at least another level. You've got a fantastic universe here. And the character design, ironically, usually with these indie studio games, you don't get that attached. From the very get-go, it was like, I really like the idea of this universe. These characters have solid voice acting, and yet there didn't seem to be a very recognizable soundtrack to accompany this world. I'm thinking StarCraft II, Wings of Liberty, Old West, mixed with this new sci-fi universe, could have really added so much more charm and personality, especially in the hub in between missions. These hubs, you walk around, talk to your teammates, unlock new challenges for the upcoming mission. It's just creepy how quiet it is. And I think it could have benefited big time from just a little bit more personality, more of an apparent score occupying some of these in-between spaces. And for as polished as the game is, the price tag of $50 is an interesting one. I think for many players, when you think about an indie studio game, you think about a little bit lower of a price point. The presentation of this game and the overall polish when it comes to that voice acting and character design definitely put it in an interesting spot to where, for some folks, if you really like this gameplay style, it very much is worth that entry cost, especially if you're going to dive into the multiplayer. But if that initial gameplay experience doesn't resonate with you, let's say you're somebody who doesn't like to issue commands, you totally don't like managing other units, I don't know if this is going to be something that pulls you in. If you're purely just an FPS fan, it's absolutely worth trying this to see if it's something that fits within your range of stuff you enjoy. But at the same time, I can see a lot of FPS players going, yeah, I don't really want to manage these units. It's not my cup of tea. To round things out though, I really like the unique gameplay experience this provides. And I want to see more fresh blends and takes on these kinds of genres because this pushes things forward. And V1 Interactive has an awesome universe here with some fun gameplay designs. If that story pacing was maybe just a little bit better and the music punched up the experience that extra amount, it would be a no-brainer for most players. As such, I think it's a great foundation, and if you like this style of gameplay, take a look. The multiplayer mode looks fantastic, and I will try and share some of those impressions with you guys after I've had some time in there once the game launches. I want to thank you guys very much for watching. As always with these unique games, you'll have to decide for yourself if it sort of fits into your preferences. It's a great universe, and I wish V1 Interactive the best. Most of the issues that I didn't like were so exterior to the core experience that it didn't really take away from that actual story campaign. I had a good time, it's cool, it just may not fit everybody's preferences, you know? Thanks for watching, like the video if you enjoyed, please subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys again in the next one.